Hey, Facebook. Happy Friday. Let me get adjusted. Let me get comfy for this because I'm a little bit fired up this morning. I have had a lot on my mind lately, and I wanted to share because maybe this will reach somebody that needs to hear it. So I'm just gonna dive right in because honestly, most of you guys are gonna be watching the replay anyway. So I saw a post that this week that kind of really rubbed me the wrong way, even though I don't think that I took it the way that it was meant. But it was, do you want to be rich or do you want to be right? And I was like, what an awful message, right? Because I want to feel right about what I'm doing. And then it also made me think about, like in marriage, like with little petty arguments, you want to be right or you want to be happy. But like I said, I probably misinterpreted it. But had I not been going through this like personal soul searching lately, I wouldn't have taken it so personal. But let me just kind of backtrack and share a little story. Hey guys, everybody that's jumping on. I know Brandy, because me and you were like this girl. But I took a journey this past summer, and for those of y'all that know or don't know, I am in network marketing, and then this isn't a any really anything about like recruiting or products or anything like that, but just like, hear my heart. I hope that you hear my heart. I hope I can stay on track to where you can hear my heart in this. But I was very fulfilled with what I was doing. I wasn't looking for any type of change or any add-on or anything like that. But I decided to take kind of this, I guess you could call it a leap of faith back in June, and go a different direction. And it has been ups and downs for me, knots in my stomach of, oh my God, did I make the right decision? I don't think I did. Guess I'm gonna do this. I mean, it's been annoying, honestly. So sorry for Brian and my friends that I've like talked my way through this throughout the summer, but like I am so much driven by fulfillment and leading with my heart that I have to believe in what I'm doing or I don't do it. Like I've asked Brian plenty of times back when I was a teacher, a classroom teacher, and Brian, his job, like he's a provider. He works to make money for our family, and it's not something that necessarily fulfills him. And I'm like, oh my God, how do you spend your days doing something you just don't love? Like that sucks. Because when I was a teacher, I loved that. That was fulfilling to me. I can't imagine having a career, spending all my time doing something that I just didn't believe in and passionately love. So that's just who I am. Anyways, I'm going through this like soul searching thing, and I met with a leader within our church this past week, not in relation to this, but we're talking about volunteering and kind of finding where I could best fit in helping out at our church. And so he was asking just in general what I wanted to do. And then he asked me this just really heavy question of, what is my mission in life? And like what matters to me so much that it brings out a lot of emotion in me, it kind of brings you to tears. And I'm like, oh my God, that's such a good question. Let me tell you. So I kind of told him my conflict of what I was dealing with. And I just was like, what is my message? What am I doing? Why am I doing any of this? And it just stumped me. So I came home, I've been praying about it, and I was looking in the wrong place, you guys. Like I was looking at it company to company. And it was just kind of, I now that I feel like I've had this big aha, kind of silly because I was investing in like, should I do this company or should I do this company? And so I reached out to my angel, my just thank God for Mark McDonald. I love you if you are watching this, but just he is that clarity person for me, the one that I hear on my shoulder all the time. And so I reached out to him this morning, and I'm like, so I've made my decision. I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna move forward with this company or whatever. And he said, Kathleen, you got it all wrong. You have to understand it's about you and building you, branding you, which that's a term that we use a lot in my world, but branding yourself and what matters to you the most. What is your message? Really, it's your vision. What's your vision? And then you take it down. What's your mission? And then you get clear on your message. So I was like, there we go again. Since day one, for 2 years, he's been telling me this, and I still wasn't clear in that. But let me tell you what my message is, you guys, why I do this. And for anyone that does follow me, it's kind of weird to say that, but watch what I put out there. I care about helping, empowering people to do better and be better, no matter what. I don't care about products. Products are great. There's a lot of products. There's a lot of good companies and all that jazz. But I want to be that little birdie on some people's shoulders where they hear me, whether it's move it, drink more water, make better health decisions, or, you know, knowing that you have that personal power to change your life, that you're not destined to be a loser, you're not destined to be unhappy, or, you know, whatever is dragging you down. I want to be that. And so I want to grow myself and develop myself enough to where I can empower, you know, whatever that number of people is, whether it's one person, 5,000 or whatever, that's a lot. But, you know, and like, do I want to make money? Yes. Do I want to help people? Yes. But I want to have real relationships with people, not where they feel like I'm scrambling at the end of the month because, oh my God, I have to do so many more sales. And like, it's all about me and what I need to do, because that today's the last day of the month. You know what? I don't really care. It's another day in the month, and that's just fine with me. But that's another topic about pushing your personal goals on other people. But anyways, I got off topic on the look at my notes for just a minute, because I'm super fired up, because this has been a really tough decision for me. So I want to help empower people. And if I make money doing that, great. That means people come to me because they trust me. They trust my recommendation on things because they know that I'm honest. They know that I'm sincere and that I lead with my heart. And so, do you want to be rich or do you want to be right? You guys, there's a lot of hype out there. There's so much hype in my Facebook feed and all over this that I'll never contribute to that. It makes me sick. If you're promoting, I'm going to talk about weight loss for a minute, some magic solution of, oh my God, look at all this fat melting off of me, and I eat pizza every night and I drink wine and I'm still dropping all this. Shame on you. Shame on you for promoting that. Shame on you for promoting it in that way and contributing to the yo-yo dieting society that's just going to lead to desperation, more desperation, people pouring money out to fuel your personal financial goals and keeping them miserable because you're not educating them, you're not empowering them to make positive life choices, and the hype is BS. And so I'll never get rich on hype, and I may never get rich, and I'm okay with that because my life is blessed, and I'm okay with saying that. That doesn't mean I stop my growth. That doesn't say I don't want to build my business. That doesn't mean I don't want to make money. I want to make money the right way. So if you do come to me, you can trust me and what I recommend to you. If you want to pay for my coaching so I can coach you through a program, then that's fine. If you want to join my team because you like what I'm doing, you want to be a part of that, that's great. It may be a slower race, but you know what? I'm going to win, and I'm already winning because I'm not going to feed into the hype and get rich the wrong way. So that's it. I'm fired up, and I just don't like all the hype. And shame on you if you fueled that just to financially gain off of other people. So be better than that. Be better and do better. Have a great day, you guys. Happy Friday.